previously on Gunpla Note.
But today we are going to start our culling process. And yeah, as usual, we will begin with the direct approach, which is just apply a opaque layer. Lots of blue in it. It's a pretty dark blue and just a tiny little bit of black. Yeah, that's why you don't want to use the airbrush in a rainy day, because the humid in the air, you will only accumulate in your
Hello everybody, this is Archnote. So today we're gonna continue our direct approach, and this time we only have one color left, that is black. And as usual, we're gonna do some taping first. As you see, I tape out, take out some of the reusable tape, and remember, just use it two times the most. So we'll toss them away next time. And one thing about I skip is the rocket launcher with the bazooka. Well, it's because as you can see, there's a lot of turns here and there, and I still have to use the needle tool to refine all the edges, because I did it yesterday. But yeah, this really gives me a lot of hard time, and I believe it will still, when I'm trying to cover the black we're trying to paint today, before we go into the white part. So yeah, just beware, this probably will be the most difficult ones, but the rest, I think it won't be that hard. Like the funnels, they are pretty straight lines, and the this small stuff, and all the here and there, it's just tiny spot. Right, so we'll start with the taping process, and we'll go into the outside studio to begin our painting process. Let's just get started. Thank you.
Thank you.
Alright, now we finally finish all the black parts for direct approach. It's a little bit more, the paint. Apparently, I miscalculated the amount of paint I need, since I thought the black is pretty dark, so you don't have to apply pretty thick layer. But however, since the paint is like a little bit transparent, so yeah, it's just the characteristic of the pigment, I believe. So it have to apply a little bit more than I expected, so that's why I have to use like 2 batch of this container. However, we did it, and it looks pretty nice to me. I think black and yellow, you know, goes pretty well together. So yeah, I think I made the right call, and the texture of it, I pretty like it. And if you feel like this is too flashy, you know, compared to the yellow part, don't worry. We will make it consistent, and when we apply the clear coat, so it won't be that much like a difference between 2 colors. Alright, that's all for today's session. If you enjoyed this, please drop a like, leave a comment, and I will see you all in the next video.